Senator Blunt.
Mr. Chairman, I have an amendment. This amendment it deals with an issue that was addressed in the House bill that would have reauthorized this, what we're reauthorizing today. Like Senator Markey, I want to talk about my amendment, then I intend to withdraw it because I do believe the overall bill is ready to move forward. I appreciate the efforts you've made there, but this is a good time for me to point this out to the committee on behalf of myself and a number of my colleagues on this committee and in the Senate generally. The FCC announced within the last year that a practice that they had allowed in a number of areas would no longer be allowed and would no longer be allowed for people that they had told they could move forward with what's called a joint sales agreement. In small stations, I'm told, particularly in stations where people are trying to get into this business, particularly minority ownership is talked about as one of the things that these joint sales agreements allow to happen. We've seen these applied in helpful ways. In Joplin, Missouri, there are two stations. We have more than that in our state. There are two stations that, by going together, they were able to have Doppler radar equipment that allowed the kind of alerting to happen before that tornado in 2011 that, frankly, those two stations at least wouldn't have had as the standalone stations they had previously been. The FCC decisions puts whatever benefits, the benefits here at risk, and I think even more unfairly, it puts them retroactively in a place where lots of decisions were made, money was borrowed, determinations about the ongoing capacity of those stations were out there, that suddenly the FCC says, well, we don't really care what you were told you could do in the past, you cannot do it. I actually think the policy would be a good policy to have as a permanent policy, but at the very least, I believe the FCC and or the Congress should allow people who were given the authority to have these agreements to continue to have them. Lots of decisions were made based on this. The FCC is given 2 years to unwind these agreements. The House added an additional 6 months, so that would have been 30 months to unwind the agreement. I think that's the only problem with that is it doesn't undo the decisions that were made based on the willingness of the government to say move forward with these. So this amendment grandfather these provisions in. Senator Wicker, Senator Scott, and Senator Johnson have joined me as co-sponsors of the amendment. And so in addition to talking about the amendment, I'm also going to put in the record two letters, one from organized by Senator Tim Scott, co-signed by several members of this committee, sent to the FCC. Another one really was put together by Senator Mikulski and Senator Schumer with four other signatures, and it was sent to the FCC, and they both make the same case in slightly different ways that this is really an unfair thing for the government to do. It's a place where our committee at some future date in the next 24 months, I would hope, would step in sooner rather than later and say the government can't tell people they can do something and then people act on that permission to do something and then the government in future months because the chairman of some commission changes or the commission changes thinks they can just decide, well, we're sorry, but we don't think that's a good idea anymore. That is not an acceptable place for the government to be, and I'll put these letters on the record. I'll withdraw my amendment and hope we deal with this at a later time.